Picture this, you have a job, you're employed, and then somewhere along the line, you develop an interest in design. You start doing a few side hustles for clients here and there, only for those side hustles to grow into a $60,000 worth of a startup in less than 4 years. Sounds too good to be true, right? Well, that is exactly the story of my guest today, and I can't wait to introduce you to him. My guest today is founder and creative director of Wexer Brand, and he has such an amazing story. I can't wait you guys to hear it right from the host's mouth. So welcome to my show, Samuel Wekesa.
Yeah.
It's such a great honor to host you.
Thank you for having me.
I want us to start right into your story because you have quite an incredible story. And your last job before you started Wexer Brand was not even related to branding at all. So how did you get into this space?
I always had a passion for design and creativity. And ever since I was in high school, I had an interest in just design. And though I took computer studies, but my interest was more of just how the outlook of a software or a website. So I realized mine is more of a design. So that's when I realized that it's something that I need to pursue.
So at what point during your last job, at what point did you realize that you can actually create an income in the design side of things?
What happened is I used to offer my services pro bono based on a need. It actually came based on a need. The church where I was going, the department that I was serving, they always needed like a flyer or a poster or something. And when I used to create for them, that's when I realized that people started appreciating. Oh, this is nice. Oh, who did this for you? So yeah, okay. I think I can.
Really
yeah,
this
is something that I can actually do. Because before that, I thought, maybe I'm gonna be an IT guy, which I still am. But now, design just came out of that experience of just offering it as a service, like a by the way.
Now, not so many young people create a smooth transition from employment to entrepreneurship.
Yes.
And you jumped right from your job to starting Wexer Brand, and in less than 4 years now, your business is what about $60,000. So how was that transition like? How was that transition for you? What made it easier or possible for you to start out?
What made it easier for me is while I was still in employment, I offered my service at a part-time rather basis. So during my extra hours, I will design for people, and slowly by slowly I built my clientele. And you see, the beauty of our industry is if you are good at something, the referral will always be
your biggest
advantage. So because somebody sees your work and refers you to somebody else, and that way, before you know it, you already have a base of clients. And also, I created this impression that I am a company, though I was just one person. So I registered.
So you brought your creative thinking into your human resource.
Exactly, because I realized there are some of the clients that I wanted my services, but they couldn't gauge me because I am a freelancer. So for me to be able to work with them, they needed to work with a company. So that's where the need for me now registering as a company. So I just first registered as a business with a business name, and just got the right documents just so that I can be able to get some of these opportunities.
And I hope you're getting that information, because it's really important to, I would call it, professionalize your craft. Because there are jobs that will not be given out here because you're an individual. Either people will limit tend to limit your capacity because you're just a person. Mm-hmm. But once you professionalize your craft and give the impression that you can be reliable, because once you have a company, there's a name on that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and also something else that you've mentioned, Sammy, is that you created an impression that you're a company. Mm-hmm. This means that you also, other than just the name, other than just the name Wexer Brand, you had people around you that could offer their services as well to help you deliver on the jobs. And that's we'll call that partnerships and collaborations, which is something that your company is really passionate about. So could you just tell us, on all the other young people out there who wants to venture into business, just the importance of collaborations and partnerships and what role they play in giving you that push?
The mistake people do mostly is they think they can do everything for themselves, and you want to be the CEO, you want to be the technical guy, you want to be the key person, you want to be everything. And What that does, it dilutes your ability to deliver, because now you're putting a lot on yourself. So there's power in delegation. Just find the right people who are as passionate as you, who believe in your vision. And once you work together, then what you create is a masterpiece, because now you've distributed the efforts to people who are capable in certain areas. So when you merge everything, now you can be able to deliver quality. Impression was really key, because what I used to do, I am one person, the only employee, I was still employed, and I had all these emails, like info@Wexer. Some at Wexer, accounts at Wexer. So people will think you're talking to
a big department,
but I was actually answering all those emails. Yeah, you speak to my accounts. I will speak to my accounts to get back to you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So people will think, this is a big company, hey. But I hope they don't watch.
The important thing is not the impression that you created, but about the work that you
delivered. At the end of the
day. And delivering you did.
Yes.
And so maybe about how did you, again, manage your human resource? Because I know at some point you will get so much jobs, and like you said, you're just one person. So how did you make now that transition from you to getting now extra hands until now that time that you are like, okay, now we have a team?
One of the most important thing when you venture out is having a clear vision on why you're doing what you're doing. And you just being a good designer or good at what you do is not enough. You have to find a meaning and a purpose to what you're doing. And that is what people will buy. Why are you doing this? How does it impact you? You as the receiver of my services, and any stakeholder, once they understand your vision, it's easy for them to plug in, because they will find their space within your vision. But if it is just for money, or we are just doing it to get income, you can only go as far.
Sure.
Yeah, but if you have a vision, you have a meaning to what you're doing, it helps you even overcome the challenges, because the vision is attractive enough for you to understand that these are just challenges for the moment. So I had people who really supported me as mentors, and also I was able to get a partner to be able to buy into my vision. I actually designed
a business partner.
Yeah, and I was able to package myself, create a business plan. I'm not good with creating business plans, so I had people who assisted me with that, and everything was just now taking shape, and then you sit down and realize actually I have a bigger mandate. And it is just not enough anymore to do a one-man show. If I want to achieve this, I have no choice but to involve other people. Yes.
So there's always this mindset where people are usually waiting for the perfect condition, the perfect time, so that they get started. Yeah. But in your case, that was not the case for you. Like you, all you needed was a computer and softwares, and here you are now. What is your word to that person who is waiting and saying, I'll start this and when I get, when I have a certain capital, or I'll venture into this when I have the right equipment? What is your advice to that person who has, who is bubbling with ideas, but they're just seated on the ideas? How do they move to the next level?
What I would say to young people who want to venture into entrepreneurship is, I'm a very strong believer in vision. Find a meaning first. Find your vision. Why are you doing what you're doing? Or why do you want to do what you want to do? And how does it impact the society? Because we are all skillful. There are a million designers, there are a million photographers, there are a million everyone. So what differentiates us is the reason why we are doing what we are doing and how it impacts the society, because we are here to serve each other. I'm here to add value to you. You're here to add value to somebody else. And together now we make each other better. So finding that meaning to what you're doing is the first point, because it is not a must to get into entrepreneurship. It is not a must. Maybe at that particular point you can work under somebody. But if you're gonna venture out, let money not be your motivator. I know most people it will be. But to me, money is just a byproduct. It is just an evidence or a receipt that indicates that I offered somebody a service and I was paid for it. And once I'm paid, it is only for my growth and the growth of the people around me. So let vision be your motivation, because it will, you can never reach at the end of that vision, but you always get closer. So if you have something that you always look towards, and it's as if like you will never get towards it, you see, that is long term. But if it's money, challenges will always come, and then times come you don't have, and then you find that now you want to change into something else, because here I military, so I move to this, I move to that, and then at the end of the day you sit down, you're like, okay,
spreading yourself,
this thing is not working.
So 4 years down the line, what are the biggest challenges right now in entrepreneurship, and especially for a young person?
The biggest challenge is cash flow. Yeah, there are a lot of you find there are a lot of overheads, you know, people delaying payments, and of course now trying to be right with the authorities, you know, KRA, the council and all that, just trying to keep up, keep your business aligned with the legal entities. And just that, getting those opportunities too. Especially with big corporates, you know, it's not that easy. You have to be patient. You have to try and work with smaller businesses, just at least to keep you going as you pursue.
Great. So what is your advice as we conclude to aspiring entrepreneurs, or just any young person out there who is trying to make ends meet?
Have a vision. I have a very clear vision of where you're going with your business, which audience you want to impact, because I believe it is my personal belief that each and every business should be a social enterprise. Not just for making money, it is for impacting people.
Exactly.
You know, that way, it's sustainable, and any challenges that you will face, you can cruise through because you've found a meaning in what you're doing. So when you have financial challenges, when you go through stuff, at least you have something that keeps you focused. So that is very important because you need to do things for the long term.
Yeah.
It is good to get money, but that shouldn't be your motivation. It will come on its own naturally. If you just add value to people. It is very simple. It is very simple. That's why if you go buy a certain phone and they tell you, hey, this phone is 50K, there are two reactions. If somebody says that phone is expensive, probably it's because you feel the value of that phone and the cost of that phone, the cost is higher than the value. That is, so expensive is relative. But if the value is higher than the cost, then you won't feel.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So expensive is relative. So always give value and people will pay for it without feeling that you are ripping them off.
Yeah.
So that is what we try to do, because like I've kept talking about vision. Our vision is changing culture. And we do this by inspiring a culture that promotes authentic brands which people can connect to. So that is our focus area. Any brand that we serve is authentic. They're actually offering the value that they claim to offer, and it's something that people can connect to for the long term. And that's why our motto is turning your prospects into lasting friends. It's all about relationship, it's all about community, it's all about helping each other become better. Whether I'm selling mails, whether I'm selling smiley, I will not sell you bad smiley, I will sell you good smiley so that you're healthy. So everything should be about how do I add value to the next person to become better in whatever they do.
Wow. Great, guys, that is what Voices is all about. Like, being an active citizen, it's part of being an active citizen is about taking up opportunities around you, not just to empower yourselves, but those around you, because that is what sustainable development is all about. I'm sure you're learning so much from Sami Wekesa. And so I would like to hear you guys, if you have any questions that you need to ask regarding Sami's journey, please share in the comment sections below, and I'm sure we are going to respond. Also, if you want to reach to Sami for business, Wexer Brand, they're all about branding. We'll share the details in the description box below. You can find a link to their website and also emails, relevant emails. Okay, I think actually a link to their website will give you everything you need to find out. Yes, so guys, thank you so much for watching. It's always a pleasure having these conversations with you.